Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's me, Scott. Thank you very much for joining us. As you can see, we're back. We're doing another group prediction. This time it's Group B in the World Cup in Qatar, obviously starting later this month. Very excited for it. We're doing a lot of World Cup content on the channel. I hope you enjoy it. We're on to Group B, and that's England, Iran, USA, and Wales. Same time as last time, we're going to pick out 10 packs of the Panini World Cup stickers that you'll have seen on the channel already. We're going to open these up and we are going to see how many players or badges or anything else we get from each country. And for each one of those, we're going to put them into piles. Whoever gets the most goes through top of the group. Whoever gets the least is knocked out. And then obviously that all important second place is up for grabs. If we end up with level numbers of cards, what we will do is we will flip over the stickers that we've got, and the one with the highest number is going to finish top or finish or get knocked out. If we don't have a player from any clubs, we're going to go into sudden death and start opening more packs, which I didn't bring with me into the room, so I'm going to have to go and get them. We're going to do this for each group, so there's 8 of these, so we're going to do this as we go. We're opening the first pack, and let's see who we get. Al Awas, Talbi, I apologize for these names. We have Joe Roden putting Wales top of the group. Interesting. We have Denier from Belgium, and then we have an Ecuadorian. Could have done with him last time out. Okay, that's pack number one, and we already have one card. Not great for the English. Wales picking up a win early on. Okay, we have Pedri. We have the Japan team. We have the Mexican Alvarez. We have Iranian Azmoun. That's Wales and Iran currently qualifying, and Mensah there for Ghana. Wow, what an upset this would be if England don't go through. That being said, England have been pretty terrible in the build-up to this World Cup, so it'll be interesting to see how that goes. We've got Sosa from Croatia, Oliveira from Uruguay, Argentinian here, Gonzalez, another South American in Brazilian Rafinha, and then Raheem Sterling coming through clutch, making it 1-1-1 at this moment in time, level on points. The only team yet to pick up a point are the Americans. I don't think I've missed one. Okay, Gutierrez from Mexico. We've got Ifa from Tunisia. We've got Canadian Jonathan David. We've got a second Welshman in Brennan Johnson, putting them firmly top of the group. And then Argentinian down here. I'm just going to quickly flick through. I don't think I've missed any Americans, but you know, they're easily missed. No, they're not. That's a lie. Okay, no Americans so far. Right, this is an exciting group. It's level pegging going into the last few packs here. Oh, I missed a sticker. Who is it? It's stuck to the front of the pack. Who is it? It is Furuhashi from Japan. We have Serbian Lucic. We have Cameroonian Kundi, Canadian Henry, and then the Moroccan team. We are counting the badges as double. So if we pick up a badge for a nation in the group, it will be worth double. We have Harry Maguire putting England ahead of Iran. We have the Australian badge. Oh, hello. No, we have a Al Faraj. We have a Pezzella, and then the Belgium shiny badge. Doesn't mean anything in this pack, but obviously would have been double points for Belgium. Okay, we've got another sticker stuck to the front. It is Gondouin. We have Okafor. We have the France 98 squad there. We have German Leroy Sané, and we have the Senegalese squad. We're on to the last three packs. This is going to be tight coming into the end here. America still to get off the mark. Let's see if that changes anytime soon. We have Jordi Alba, Dejan Lovren, the boy Alisson, We have Serbian Radanovic, and we have Koulibaly. Okay. Let's have a look who we've got here. Let's open this up. We've got this fella whose name I'm not going to pronounce even remotely correctly. We have the Australian squad. We have Wayne Hennessy for Wales, making it 3-2. We have Dest for the USA, and we have Muharami for Iran, making it 2-2 to Iran and England, going into the last pack. Holy crap, we have Neco Williams for Wales, making it 4 for them. Huge for Wales. And Marty here. And then we have Ericsson. Nice to see him there. We have Ecuadorian. And we have Jovic, for Serbia. So the only way we can do this is turn these over, and whatever number of these stickers is the highest is the team going through. So let's start here. We have for Senegal number 10, and we have for England number 7. We have for Iran we have number 18, that's huge, and for England we have number 20. England scrape through by the absolute skin of their teeth, thanks to Raheem Sterling. Brave effort from Iran. America, thanks for turning up. So Wales going through top of the group, England squeaking through in that second place, and Iran, brave fight they put up, unfortunately knocked out. I hope you enjoyed this. We're going to do an update of this sticker pack as we go, so we've got quite a lot of stickers now to stick in it. We're going to do some more of these with the adrenaline cards. I'd love to know your prediction for Group B. Sorry, England, Iran, Wales, and USA. Who do you think's going through in that group? And again, I'd love to hear your stories about World Cups you've been to or watched or can remember, and your favourite moments. Thank you so much for watching. Please hit the like button, subscribe button, follow us on Twitter and TikTok. Links are all in the description below, and I'll see you again.